Welcome to the Speed, Time and Distance series. We are now going to discuss about the part 3. In part 3, we are going to focus when one person is going on the road with a certain speed and another person will catch that person after some time. So how long it will take to catch that person? Second question is, if one boy is running at a speed of certain distance and another boy is running after him, after a certain period of time, so when will the another boy is going to catch the boy who ran first? So these type of questions are there, and we are going to learn all the ideas and the application part of this particular concept on speed, time and distance through solving different questions on speed, time and distance. So I welcome to all of you in this part number 3. I request that better you go to part 1, part 2, and then you can see part 3, so you can understand everything in a logical sequence. So let's start. A boy starts from his home at 10 a.m. The boy is starting at 10 a.m. and with a speed of 12 kilometers. So this is a boy who is starting from his home at 10 a.m. with a speed of 12 kilometers per hour. His brother went on scooter. That is, this is his brother. He went on a scooter after 1 hour and 15 minutes. So after 1 hour and 15 minutes, and caught his brother at 1:30 p.m. and he is going to catch this boy, his brother, at 1:30 p.m. So this boy started at 10 a.m. He started at 10 a.m. and after 1 hour and 15 minutes, his brother starts. So at 11:15, his brother is going to start on scooter. So when his brother is going to start, he has covered a distance of 15 kilometers in 1 hour and in 15 minutes. Because when his brother is going to start, he will be 15 kilometers ahead from his brother. And his brother is going to meet at 1:30. So after 2 hours and 15 minutes, they meet. So boy has covered at a speed of 12 kilometers per hour from 10 to 1:30. So he walked 4.5 hours. He walked 4.5 hours. So in 3.5 hours, he covered 42 kilometers. So when you apply the distance is equal to speed into time, then the distance is coming 19.53. This is a long way. The short trick is, when here the question is they will caught each other or they will meet each other. So more distance divided by the relative speed. Now the relative speed means they are walking in the same direction. So relative speed will be S2 minus S1. His brother started at 11:15 and caught at 1:30. So he was driving his scooter for 2 hours and 15 minutes. So in 2 hours and 15 minutes we convert into an hour. So 15 into 60, that is 1 over 4. So 2 into 1 over 4, that is 9 upon 4 hours. So time to caught in 9 over 4 hours. So 9 over 4 hours, and distance already traveled by the boy from 10 to 11:15. He covered a distance of 15 kilometers. Scooter of the speed is not given, so we assume it is x. And walking speed of a boy is already given, it is 12 kilometers per hour. So now you put 9 over 4 is equal to 15 kilometers, x minus 12. Here x means speed of a scooter. So when you are solving this equation, you will get x is equal to 19.33 is the speed of the scooter. Or you can say 19.33 kilometers per hour is the speed of the scooter. Next question. P and Q is 27 kilometers from each other. So this distance is 27 kilometers. Two trains starts from P and Q. So one train is going into this direction. Another train is going into this direction. At a speed of 24 kilometers, here it is 24 kilometers and 18 kilometers respectively. So direction is opposite, it means relative speed is equal to speed 1 plus speed 2. So speed 1 is 24 kilometers and speed 2 is 18 kilometers. So total it will be, speed will be 42 kilometers per hour. And what is the distance? Distance is already been given, it is 27 kilometers per hour. So time to meet each other or cross each other is 27 kilometers, and this is the relative speed, that is 42 kilometers per hour, and 22 kilometer has gone, so it is 0.64 or 1 hour and 4 minutes. Next, Alex and Bill start their journey from point P at 6 a.m. and 7:30 a.m. So this is an Alex and this is Bill. Alex is going to start his journey at 6 a.m. at a speed of 6 kilometers per hour. And Bill is starting his journey at 7:30 and his speed is 12 kilometers per hour. Now you can see both are running in the same direction. So when they are running in the same direction, speed, relative speed will be s2 minus s1. So it is 6 kilometers per hour. So the time to meet each other is 9 kilometers, because when this person Bill is going to start, at that time Alex has covered 9 kilometers. So Bill has to cover 9 kilometers to Alex. So here the more distance is 9 and relative speed is, this person Alex is running at 6 kilometers per hour and Bill is running at 12 kilometers per hour. So the difference of their speed is a relative speed, so that is 6 kilometers. So 9 divided by 6, it means 1.5 hours. It means 7:30 plus 1.5 hour. So at 9 a.m. they are going to meet each other. Next question, the distance between A and B is 60 kilometers. So let's say this is A and this is B and the distance is 60 kilometers. Two person, Rajesh and Karan, start from A to B. So Rajesh and Karan is starting to run from A point to B point. Karan's speed is 4 kilometers less than Rajesh's speed. So we don't know about the Rajesh's speed. So let us assume Rajesh's speed is equal to x. And Karan's speed is 4 kilometers less than the Rajesh's speed. So Karan's speed will be x minus 4. Rajesh reach at B. He reach at B and return from B to A. Then Karan met Rajesh at a distance of 12 kilometers. So from here to here, where the Karan is still coming, Rajesh is meeting him at 12 kilometers. So So time is same for Rajesh and Karan because both are running at the same time and the same duration. But Karan walked 48 kilometers. That time Rajesh walked 48 kilometers. How? Because let's say A to B is 60 kilometers. When Rajesh is returning, he covered 12 kilometers. It means Karan is at 60 minus 12. It means 48 kilometers. That is the kilometer covered by Karan. And Rajesh is completing 60 and going back and completing 12. So he covered 72 kilometers. And now you need to find out the time. So 72 is the Rajesh speed. Rajesh completing the distance and x is the speed. Karan is completing the distance of 48 and his speed is x minus 4. When you are going to cross multiply these two equation, the 72 will be multiplied by x minus 4 and this is 48x. When I am solving this equation, x is going to be 12. Now x means the Rajesh speed is 12 and current speed is minus 4 from the 12. So current speed is 8 kilometers per hour. The distance between A to B is 21 kilometers. Joseph and Reggie start walking together at a speed of 3 kilometers and 4 kilometers. So here is Joseph. His speed is 3 kilometers per hour. And here is Reggie. His speed is 4 kilometers per hour. Both are starting from point A and towards point B together at the same time. Reggie reached at point B and turned immediately and returns towards A. So Reggie reached over here by completing 21 kilometers, and after completing 21 kilometers, he is going towards A. He met Joseph at point R. So this is the point R, where Joseph is still coming towards B. Find out the distance from A to R. So we have to find out the distance from A to R. So Joseph completed X kilometers. Joseph is completing X kilometers. At that time, Reggie is completing 21 kilometers plus this distance. So this distance is 21 minus X. So Reggie covers 21 plus 21 minus x kilometers. It means the Joseph is completing distance x in 3 kilometers. At that time, the Reggie is covering 21 plus 21 minus x in 4 kilometers. When we are going to cross multiply this equation with this, then we will get x is equal to 18 kilometers. Now, here they are asking the distance from B to R, means 21 minus X. We already found out what is X is equal to. So X is equal to 18. So BR is 3 kilometers. Next question. Ali, Birju and Khalid walked 1 kilometer for 5 minutes, 8 minutes and 10 minutes. Respectively, they started their journey at point C at the same time. So they are starting a journey C at the same time. Birju started his journey after 1 minute from Khalid. So Khalid is the first. This is the second who started, and Ali started at the last. Ali started after 2 minutes from Khalid. So after first minute, Birju start, and after 2 minutes, Ali start. After 1 minute, Birju start. So we need to find out how much time Ali caught Birju and Khalid. So we know Khalid went first, Birju went second, and Ali went third. So time to meet or cross each other is more distance divided by the relative time speed. So distance is 1 upon 8 divided by 3 over 40. So it is 5 of 3. Time to caught Birju by Ali. Now time to court Khalid by Ali. So Khalid is starting, Ali is starting after 2 minutes. So 110 is the speed, multiply by 2, so you will get this much distance, divided by the relative speed. So relative speed is 1/5 minus 110. So 210 divided by 110. So it is after 2 minutes. So here we are completing the part 3 of time and distance. So these are the questions which I have timed. I have explained by pictures. So just take out the questions and try to solve on your own, and then you can repeat the practice if something is coming wrong. Thank you very much. We will meet again in the next video.